Hello investors, my name is Dehan. Welcome back to your number one place for all your investing needs. In today's video, we're going to be looking at four potential altcoins to buy right now. So the market has been performing very, very well for the past few weeks. As we can see right here, obviously in the past 24 hours, we've seen a little bit of a pullback slash sideways trading. The market is down about 1.41% from the highs. Now, top gainers in the past 24 hours, Harvest Finance, which is up about 53%. Highest volume, like usual, is going to be Bitcoin. So Bitcoin pretty much trading flat, still around this 44,000 area. We did hit close to 45,000 at one point. Now, Ethereum down about 3.5%. So it went to highs of about 3,100, almost 3,200 at one point. And then we pulled back down to about 3,000 level right now, which is still great, obviously. It's just a slight pullback, and then hopefully we'll continue that continuation on the upside. Now, we see all these other altcoins are following the same trend, down about 2 or 3%. Doge is flat. Everything else is down about 2 or 3%. Nothing looks green right now, so obviously there are going to be some outliers. So right now, guys, before we get into this, four altcoins, smash that like button for me. Let's aim for 150-plus likes on this video. Subscribe to the channel. We're aiming for 40,000 subscribers. If you guys want to sign up for Webull and get your two free stocks valued up to $2,300. Links can be in the description for that. And as always, leave a comment below letting me know what crypto are you looking to buy right now. So the first altcoin on our list is going to be Helium. So Helium, also known as HNT. A lot of you guys might not be familiar with this one, but this one gained a lot of traction in the beginning of 2021 as, a lot of people started to mine this coin. And we even actually talked about this coin actually a few months ago, but not into depth. You know, we didn't really actually talk about buying it. But right now, Helium is on the upside, up about 6.47% the past 24 hours. So it is a green coin. In the past week, it's up 5%. Past month, 14% from lows of about $9.32. On the one-year chart, this coin is up over 2,360%. Last August, it was worth about 59 cents. At the beginning of this year, $1.71. And then we just started this uptrend. Obviously, here in March and April, a lot of people started to learn about these Helium miners, and people started to buy in more, and people started to hype it up, and we got up to about almost $23 right here at one point in May. Then obviously the sell-off happened. We hit lows of about $10 once again, and now this continuation on the upside is very beautiful. We even had the halving happen in August. So the halving happened where, you know, half of the coins that were getting put out, I believe it was 5 million. Don't quote me on that exact number. If I'm saying the number incorrect, leave a comment below letting me know, and I'll pin the top comment. I believe before we were getting about 5 million coins per month mined, and now we have that into 2.5 million. Now, if you guys aren't familiar with Helium, obviously there's going to be the people network, people powered network, so you guys can mine, stake, and use. So right here, the network is live. Total hotspots, 114,000 hotspots. Over her right here, you can see right there how many circulated supply. We have over 98 million coins. So Helium mine. We have different miners. So obviously these are all the miners that we have. I actually personally bought one of these miners, and I'm still waiting. It's been about 5 or 6 months. It takes a very, very long time for these to come because there are so many people bought in at the same time around March and April. And, you know, everybody is waiting for their miners to come in. Mine is supposed to come by the end of this year. But Helium, definitely a coin to be watching. In April, a lot of people were mining, $3,000 or $4,000, even $5,000 worth of coins just in a month from this coin. But obviously, as we get, more and more miners right now, it is a lot harder to mine and a lot less profitability. So that is still okay. But Helium definitely on the upside right now, and one coin to watch for the, next few months to see what is going to happen with this one. So that is our first altcoin. Second altcoin is going to be Pancakeswap. So you guys should know about Pancakeswap. A lot of people go on there and do a lot of staking and different pools and things like that. So this one is down about 4.6% the past 24 hours. In the past week, it's up 8%. Past month, 14% from lows of $10, hitting highs here of almost $20, about $19 or so. So it almost went up about 80% or so. In the past year, this coin is up over 1,000% from lows of 51 cents in October when it started trading, all the way to highs of $44 in April. Then we saw this pullback all the way down to about $12 or $13, and we consolidated around that area for about 2.5 months. And finally, now we're seeing a little bit of a breakout, obviously, on the upside. 3.6 billion market cap volume in the past 24 hours at 414.5 million. So PancakeSwap, definitely an interesting coin. And now with this return of, cryptocurrency, we might see this one come back up to the 20s, potentially. Mid-20s would be a nice area to get back into. And obviously after that, we continue to go higher and higher. But obviously, a lot of things have to, you know, get in line and come together. Obviously, as the large cap coins go, the mid cap and the low cap coins start to make that same trend, and everything starts to get greener and greener. And that's what we want to see in the crypto market, as long as nothing sells off in the near future. So PancakeSwap, our second altcoin. Our third altcoin is going to be NEO. So NEO right here, trading at around $45 per coin. This one is down 3.7%. In the past week, it's down 2%. Past month, up 21% from lows of $25 at one point. In the past year, up 244% from lows down here of about $13 last year to highs up here of over $100. It was around $140 in May. And then obviously, you know, just got destroyed, down about $100 since then. So we lost, you know, a good chunk of our profits right there. Over 60-70% of the market value was dropped. 3.1 billion market cap on NEO. Volume in the past 24 hours at 448.6 million. So NEO, this one is a cryptocurrency and smart contract platform that supports applications written in a variety of programming languages. Fees for deploying and running smart contracts are paid with gas, which is a separate token, obviously, that you guys should be familiar with. A lot of, you know, different coins have these gas fees that they have, and obviously they use different coin compared to themselves. So NEO is still down compared to where it was, and if we see a green, you know, green market, a big uptrend in the crypto space, and people start to get back in and we see a bullish type run, I would not be surprised to see this one, you know, start to make its uptrend. Only a 3.1 billion market cap, it could easily come back to 6 or 7 billion market cap in the near future, which would bring it back to about $100 per coin, and that would give you a 100% opportunity right there. So a 2x opportunity on just NEO. So that's going to be our third coin. And then our fourth coin is going to be a greener coin, you know, that we talked about actually about 2 or 3 months ago, when the green coin started to gain traction, when Bitcoin was, you know, getting all this hate for not being you know, safe for the environment, and it was using too much of our resources. So people were looking for safer coins, greener coins like Solana, you know, different coins like that. So Aave was one of them as well. Polygon. So this one is down about 4% today, trading around this $38 range. Past week up 3%, past month 3.8%, from lows of $22 all the way to highs of about $40 right here. So almost a 90% gain or so in a matter of a few weeks. In the past year, this one is up over 1400%. Last August, it was worth $2.66, went up here to highs of $58 on that hype. So this is when we talked about the green, you know, coins that were better for our environment. So we went from $41 all the way to highs of $58. Then the market just started to sell off in general, and everything kind of crashed back down, and we, you know, hit lows down here of about $23 or so, and now we're on an uptrend. You know, 10.2 billion market cap, volume in the past 24 hours at 371.5 million. So this one is a little bit on the, you know, higher side of the market cap, not as low as the other ones that we talked about that were only about 1 to 5 billion market cap. This one is a little bit higher, over 10 billion market cap. Solana, this one is a decentralized computing platform that uses SOL to pay for transactions. Solana aims to improve blockchain scalability by using a combination of proof of stake, consensus, and a so-called proof of history. As a result, Solana claims to be able to support over 50,000 transactions per second without having to sacrifice decentralization. So that is what Solana does, and is obviously a greener coin. So as, you know, crypto gets more, you know, known and popular and accepted, greener coins are definitely going to be something that people will be looking forward to, because we are destroying and harming our environment, obviously, with crypto mining and different things like that. Not just crypto mining, we're doing so much other stuff, and the population on Earth is growing higher and higher, over 7 billion people. So we need to worry about the environment, and these greener coins could be the future of crypto trading. So that is why Solana is going to be on the list, and that's going to be our fourth altcoin. Now, guys, those were the four altcoins that we're going to be looking at. Now, after this, we're going to be looking at the rest of the market to see how everything's performing. So our favorite coin, obviously, Ethereum, almost hit highs of 3,200 at one point here on Sunday. So it was down about 3.5%, trading around this 3,000 area right now. In the past week, it's still up over 19%, past month 30%, from lows of 1,700 at one point, hitting highs, like we said, at around 3,200. In the past year, this coin's up over 658% from about $400 all the way to highs of $4,400. Then we made this pullback. Obviously, here in April, we were trading around $2,300. And then we just saw a crazy bull run happen in the crypto market. So if we compare it to the April 25th prices right here at $2,300, Ethereum is doing very well. I mean, obviously, everything was kind of overbought right here and hyped up, came back down to around this $2,100 area. So we were just consolidating, and now we're on an uptrend. So Ethereum is doing very, very well right now in 2021. only one in my opinion. Market cap, $350.7 billion. Now, if we take a look at Bitcoin, what is Bitcoin doing? Bitcoin is pretty much flat in the past 24 hours, hitting highs up here at one point of 35 or 45,000. In the past week, it's up 6%. Past month, 30% from lows of 29,000 all the way to highs, like we said, to 45,000. That is a $16,000 gain right there in a few weeks. In the one-year chart, 274%. Obviously, Ethereum is more than double, percentage-wise. It was trading at around 11,000, came up to highs of 64,000. Then we pulled back all the way to about 29,000. Now we're on an uptrend. What we're hoping for next is to break through, you know, the mid-40s, almost to the 50 level. If we can break through the 50,000 level, we might see Bitcoin continue this bull run situation even higher. So that's obviously something that we're looking forward to. We want to see more green days, obviously, in the crypto market. In the upcoming weeks, we're going to be keeping a very close eye to see if this run will continue. And obviously, all the altcoins continue as well. Market cap, it's getting back up there to that 1 trillion area. We're at 827.2 billion market cap right now. Volume in the past 24 hours at 36.7 billion. So Bitcoin doing very well. Doge pretty much trading flat, just like Bitcoin. In the past week, it's up 17%. We saw a huge pop here on Friday going into Saturday, all the way to 28 cents at one point. In the past month, it's only up 9% from 16 cents to 24 cents, which is about a 8 cents gain or about a 50% gain. On the one-year chart, up over 6,000%, guys. Obviously, this one was very hyped up here in May, or April and May, pretty much. Then it, you know, crashed down all the way to about 16 cents or so. We talked about this one going to 10 cents, but then the bull market started to, you know, have this uptrend. And obviously, even with this crazy bull market, Doge is not performing crazy. It's not, you know, going up, you know, very quickly. It is making some green, you know, days, which is obviously a positive thing for any crypto investors that are invested into Doge. I personally do not want to hold any Doge right now. I don't think that this coin is, you know, valuable or has any value for the future. In my opinion, I think it's going to be, you know, worthless. I mean, obviously there's a lot of hype going on right now, but in the future I don't think it's going to be a huge coin, and it's going to just kind of lose that hype going on around it. So 31.9 billion market cap on Doge right now. Those are, you know, the crypto coins we're watching. That is how the market is performing. Everything is pretty much trading flat in the past 24 hours. We're waiting to see what's going to happen going into Monday, obviously, and the rest of this week. So guys, if you enjoyed this type of content, smash that like button for me. Let's aim for 150 plus likes on this video. Subscribe to the channel. Turn on that bell notifications to get notified every time I make a new video. And as always, if you want to sign up for Webull, get your 2 free stocks when you sign up today, valued up to $2,300. I hope you guys enjoyed, and let's have a great rest of this week coming up. See you tomorrow.